there. I don't know if it's obvious, but I'm laying in the grass. Yeah, I am. I am laying in the grass out in the back. There's this green belt that's behind our condo and, or my condo, and it's just kind of woodsy, and I found a little grassy spot, so that's what I'm doing. I'm just laying here in the grass, and I'm about to put a video. I'm going to tack this probably to the start of another video that I just did, and sitting up. I was actually sitting up when I did that video, but just FYI, it's a stupid video. I just have to tell you that right off the bat. It's like, I want to do a video, I don't know what I want to do a video about. I think I'm just going to talk. I think I'm going to talk for a while. Think of things to say, because I kind of want to do a religious video. And maybe if I start talking, something will come out that makes sense. That kind of thing. It's about what happens. See? Look at this. See? Grass! I am lying on the grass. It's funny. Anyway, so that's what I'm going to do. That's what I did. So FYI, don't expect anything from this video. It's just kind of there. And yeah, it's one of those fluff videos I mentioned the other day that I do when I don't have anything good to do. So if you watch it, thank you. Hey. Bye. Kind of wanted to do another religious type video, and it's just some impressions that I had today. I was looking at several different videos, and you know what I think is sad? And I used to be this way, so I know exactly where they are coming from as far as Christians. They grasp at straws, any little thing to affirm for themselves that it's real, you know, any little thing. There's a rather repugnant video. It's like 4 hours long. I left a link. I had a really short little video that I just made earlier today, and there's a link in it to it's the follow-up. It's like the hangout after the hangout of the atheist thing that Matthew 4:19 did. I can't stand to watch it. First of all, it's 4 hours long, but it's just, you know, it's like, it strikes me as a bunch of atheists patting themselves on the back and congratulating themselves. like the fact that when Matthew 4:19 starts to preach, two of the participants dropped out. That would be Robin and Bionic Dance. They dropped out. And I would have too if I had been one of them, because I think that that was clearly a manipulation on the part of the host, and I would be really angry to have been misled like that. You know, and the Christians are over there going, well, you let them have plenty of time to talk. He was saying, you know, anybody have any last words before? And they're all saying, well, you know, like, we're signing off now. They're all saying, thank you so much, da-da-da-da-da. Not taking a 10-minute chunk of time to platform the case of atheism. All through the whole thing, Matthew 4:19 is arguing back and forth with the atheists about various topics. So it's not like the atheists had monopolized the whole show. I mean, Matthew 4:19 participated equally throughout the whole thing. So it's not like they're saying, well, the atheists had the whole show and you only got to do it at the end. It's like, no. they had a give and take kind of thing going on all the way to the end when Matthew 4:19 gets on his little platform and starts to preach, knowing that his audience is not at all welcoming and didn't come looking to be preached at. So anyway, I digress. I'm getting off subject here. they're talking about this, you know, like, oh, it's really telling that these two women left. Telling of what? You know, that's what, I can't think of his name now. he has a strange name. Anyway, that's what the very first person said in the video that starts off the video. It's like, how is that telling? Telling of what? You know? And then it's like, okay, well, coming from a background that I have where I worked at a Bible camp and I got to deal with a lot of really serious Christians, they just couldn't stand the Word of God. It made them physically sick. That's the power of Jesus. That's the power of the Holy Spirit. It repels the evil. And it's just like, you know, when you do an exorcism and you say, you know, quotes from the Bible over the possessed victim goes into convulsions, that's because the demon inside is reacting to the purity of the verses that you're saying from the Bible. I mean, I could totally, that's telling that the two women took off as soon as he started preaching. I could just totally see why. Now, I don't think he actually says why he calls it telling, but, or maybe he does and I skipped over it because I've found out that I can only take these very arrogant people in itty bitty pieces. So maybe after he said it's really telling that these two, maybe that's when I shut it off, but whatever. But I've been thinking about it. What could be telling? Oh, it might be that he's thinking that, oh, you know, we're seeing the power of God, you know, and it repels the atheists. They can't even stand to listen to the Word of God without fleeing in terror. But that's the kind of that's exactly the kind of stuff that Christians look for and try to, they interpret little things, you know, things that could have any number of interpretations or explanations, I should say, as whatever they want it to be to fit into their little picture. Atheists run off. It's not because they're pissed because they were duped. No, it's because they were physically repulsed by the Word of God. Yeah, so that's one time, and I've seen that before, where something very mundane happens, and it's given a very supernatural. In fact, I can even say when I was working at this camp, a friend of mine, David, I can't remember his last name though, he wanted to get into the military, and he went into, I don't know if it was, I think it was the SEALs actually. It was something big like that. SEALs training. And when he came back on leave, he came back to visit. And I remember he told me this story about this guy that was like his roommate who was, he suspected this guy had a demon. And Dave did something, said some kind of prayer to this guy, and the guy went into convulsions on the floor. You know, and at the time I heard the story, I was like, really? Wow. And now it's like, I look back and I think about it and I think, you know, probably the guy was totally, you know, kidding. Like, went into, maybe the whole thing was fake just to freak Dave out, you know? I mean, I could totally see a roommate doing a stunt like that, you know? Maybe it got out that Dave was a bit of a religious freak and, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Da, da, da. Totally falling down and going into the hole, just like straight from Exorcist, you know. And then laughing about it with his friends later. He was so convinced that I had a demon. Oh Lord. I'm trying to think of other things that I don't know. Any kind of debate, any kind of debate with Christians, it's like no matter how it turns out, no matter who wins, I personally don't see how somebody can win a debate, but I guess they judge those things. But no matter how it turns out, the Christian will go back and look at it and go, ooh, this is, we won that one, because, and they'll come up with their reasons why, or they'll find something about it to, you know, bash atheists with. So anyway, I know there's more examples, and I'm just trying to think of them. There's a serious wicked glare right, see, right there. Whoa, look, I have a halo. Oh, did I mention that I'm, oh, yes. Look, it's the angel of God lighting on my head, and I'm gonna immaculately conceive a child. Yeah, that'll happen. I'm trying to think what else, because there's... I saw a funny thing on Facebook where it was talking about... It was like a picture with a quote on it. It said something about, the evidence of God has manifested in my life in so many ways that it completely trumps your need for evidence, or something like that is what this thing said. I'm like, in other words, imaginary evidence, your idea. I mean, anything that happens to you during the day that is a good thing, you can just say, oh, well, that was God working in my life. That's evidence for God. You know, I lost my keys to my car, and I'm looking everywhere, and I, oh Lord, show me where my keys are, and then, oh, all of a sudden, there they are underneath my book. Oh, it's God at work in my life. That's just a miracle. Anyway, this is, I guess, I'm just noticing this tree next to me that doesn't have any leaves on it. Could be a unicorn. This is where I was running around the other day. This is just the little green area behind my condo. This is the part that I did when it was dark out. Yeah, that was fun. I might have to do a disproving Sasquatch video one of these days. I know a place that's really, really, you know, there's no paths. There would be no people, and I could totally scour, you know, the dark shadows for Sasquatch to prove he doesn't exist. Actually, to be completely honest, I haven't made up my mind about Sasquatch. You know, I do think that there are creatures that can be very elusive. I mean, the fact that we continue to find new life, even, you know, modern times, we continue to find new animal life. I highly doubt it, you know, that such a thing exists, but, you know, it's like, well, it's remotely possible, just because it's a legend that goes way back, you know, even the Native Americans. So, I'm not completely ruled that one out yet, but, in fact, you probably wouldn't get me going up into the mountains at night with my flashlight trying to disprove Sasquatch, because if someone told me enough Sasquatch stories while I was sitting at a campfire, I'd probably get kind of scared, you know. Okay, so that's it. This is a stupid video. I know it. But I kind of felt like doing a video today after seeing some of those videos that I watched today. And, wow, you know, all I can say is YouTube has really made me happy that I'm an atheist. Really has. It's nothing like watching other Christians. You know, and it's sad because I know in the back of my head, I know there's a lot of really great people who are Christians. I have friends who are. But then again, you see enough turds, it's hard to remember that. You start thinking, oh my God, they're all like that, you know, and it's, anyway, there sure are a lot of turds on YouTube. Yeah, there's somebody else, I'm trying to remember his name, someone just pointed him out to me, and he's like major, major bigot, but I don't know if I want to do a video about him, because I don't want to draw attention to this guy, because he's just really weird, he's just anyway, he needs to have his videos pulled. That's how bad he is. So, okay, I'm going to end this now. Thanks for watching if you have. Bye.